federal corruption trial, former New Orleans Mayor Ray Nagin. The judge in this case has made an unusual move by partially sealing the jury selection process from the public and the media as well. Reporter Blake Hansen is live at federal court now with details on this latest development. Blake?
Scott, this news is breaking within the last hour. It came down in the form of a court order by U.S. District Judge Helen Berrigan. What this court order says is that the court has recently received communications from the members of the media, one person in particular, that led the court to believe that conduct by the media might not be respected during the proceedings. And what it says is that the media and the public's privileges are suspended for part of the until the jury is sworn. So basically, for part of the jury selection process, so won't have access to that part. This order also outlays some restrictions in terms of social media, in terms of electronic devices that previously would have been allowed for use in the proceedings. And the judge says that the orders will be reconsidered during the course of the trial. Now, legal analysts say that jurors are more open when answering questions and the media is not there. But while there are some positives in the media and public not having access to this, there are also some downsides as well.
The problem with closing the courtroom to the public is that people then have a reaction that they're hiding things, that the parties or the court or somebody doesn't want us to know what's going on. And that's always the downside to whenever you seal things or close courtrooms. Ordinarily, the Justice Department has a really strong policy against closing courtrooms. And in fact, they ordinarily object if the other side wants to do that. That's not something the government's in favor of usually.
Again, so the media is sealed from parts of the jury selection process. A trial will get underway here at federal court on Monday. Live from federal court, Blake Hansen, WDSU.